Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear respected brothers and sisters in the city of Ottawa, Gatineau area, and in Canada at large, and all around the world, welcome back with a new episode from our special program during the COVID-19, Flee to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to teach us whatever beneficial for us. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us with what we read, what we learn, what we study, what we listen to. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who always say the truth, and they always work for the truth, and they always work sincerely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts their a'mal and forgives their sins. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. I would like to thank all of you, those who are watching us right now on the live streaming on Facebook of the Ottawa Muslim Association, the big mosque in Ottawa, and all those who are watching us all around the world, and they are leaving us some amazing comments and feedbacks and questions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all of you, wherever you are, and ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help all of us and give us life, inshallah, to witness the blessed month of Ramadan and enjoy it. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. I would like also to highlight the importance of our volunteers, mashallah, in the Ottawa Muslim Association. They are working hard, mashallah, bi-idhnillah, every single day. And they are serving our community. They are making da'wah and giving da'wah, subhanallah, by their actions when they extend their hands with help to all members of the Canadian community in general and our Muslim community in particular. So just to emphasize, our organization here, Ottawa Muslim Association, and our volunteers, they are not just helping Muslim community, they are helping the Canadian human community, including the Muslim community. So if you wanna be part of this, please email us at oma@ottawamosque.ca, and also you can call us, leave us your name, your phone number, your address, inshallah, bi-idhnillah, you will be able to join this team, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. And also for the Sadaqah Food Bank, we are helping the Sadaqah Food Bank in the city of Ottawa. If you want to be a volunteer, you can go ahead and come and leave us a message. If you want to help those who are in need during that specific time of the month of Sha'ban and the coming days of the month of Ramadan, whenever you are going for groceries for yourself, you can save some non-perishable items, put them in a bag, and put them or drop them off here by the door of the mosque at Ottawa Muslim Association at 251 Northwestern Avenue. And inshallah, bi-idhnillah, we are going to pick them up and make sure that they reach those who deserve whatever you are giving. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you all. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We just started yesterday speaking about fasting, Ramadan. We have been speaking about preparation of the month of Ramadan, and Ramadan now is like 10 days far from us. So we should know general information, what we started yesterday, about fasting in general and Ramadan in particular. And then also, inshallah, bi-idhnillah, in this episode tonight or today, we will know, bi-idhnillah ta'ala, about the virtues of fasting in general and the virtues of fasting in Ramadan in particular. When we fast, generally speaking, any day during the year, what do we get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dunya and akhirah? And what are the virtues of fasting the blessed month of Ramadan? What do we really get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam promise us to get? And what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepare for those righteous servants of His, those who fast, and those who read the Quran, and those who stay up during the night time, and they are performing their tarawih, their tahajjud, adhkar, reading the Quran. So we will say, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, what are the virtues of fasting in general? We will take it from the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that is narrated in Al-Imam al-Bukhari by Sayyidina Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu anhu, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him. He said, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, whoever fasts a single day for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the gap between him and the fire very big, 70 years between him or her and the fire. Whoever fasts a single day for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sincerely for him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will widen the gap and will widen the distance between him or her and the fire by 70 years. So brothers and sisters, one single day of fasting during the year, general fasting, Mondays, Thursdays, a day on the 13th, 14th, 15th of every month can take me and you away from the fire 70 years. If we come to think, the year is 365 or 66 days. This is our calendar. Is the year with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the same calculation or more or less? For sure, the year with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more. We take it from the Quran when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking and saying, وَإِنَّ يَوْمًا عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ كَأَلْفِ سَنَةٍ مِّمَّا تَعُدُّونَ. One single day in the record of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like 1,000 years of your record. So subhanallah, you can calculate one single day of fasting, how big the difference between you and the fire with just one single day. But remember, brother, remember, sister, that there is a condition in the hadith. And this condition is the scale upon which the amal is accepted or rejected. What is it? It is for Allah, sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of us, we fast, but we think that, mashallah, we are doing a very good job, and we speak about it, I'm fasting, I fast every week, I fast every month. Then we make a partner to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our amal, in our fasting, in our ibadah. In this case, we may not get the full reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is speaking about it here in this hadith. One single day of fasting generally during the year will make the gap between us and the fire of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bigger 70 years. Let's go to Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu in another hadith, and the hadith in Musnad al-Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah. Sayyidina Abu Huraira said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself said, all the deeds are expiations for the sins, except fasting, it is for me, and I am the one who reward for it. So brothers, sisters, listen to this hadith one more time. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself is saying, all the deeds that we do are considered expiations of the sins we commit, except fasting. It is for me. For who? For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is the one who rewards for it. So our salah expiates our sins. Our dua expiates our sins. Our zakah expiates our sins. Our hajj and umrah expiate our sins. All the deeds we do expiate our sins. Our sadaqah expiates our sins. But when it comes to the fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, it is for me, la ilaha illallah. How can we take this, brothers and sisters? It is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why fasting is so special? Subhanallah. We can take it from that angle. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-khaliq, the originator, al-badi', al-bari'. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unique. There is nothing or no one is like him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. He is the all-hearing, all-seeing, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he is saying, it is for me, fasting is for me, it is as if we are taking one quality of Allah's qualities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not eat. He subhanahu wa ta'ala does not drink. So when we fast, we are trying to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by taking one of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qualities, because He subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't eat. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bestowing mercy upon us, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala is rewarding us a lot for fasting, lot, and it is much better than other a'mal. So this is, brothers and sisters, general fasting. We did not come up to specific fasting like Ashura, the 10th of Al-Muharram. Allah expiates 1 year of sins. Like Arafat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expiates 2 years of sins. And also, you don't know the calculations, these years, how many years of our records, Allahu A'lam. And also, when we come to the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, the Prophet told us there is nothing more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the deeds done during these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. So we should fast them. So remember that hadith, all the deeds of the son of Adam are expiations for sins except fasting. It is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who rewards for it. Let's go to Sayyidina Hudhayfah ibn Yaman radiyallahu anhu, another sahabi. So now we took Sayyidina Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, Sayyidina Abi Huraira, and then Sayyidina Hudhayfah ibn Yaman radiyallahu anhu. Qal, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, the fitna of the man in his family and his wealth and his neighbors will be expiated by salah, siyam, and sadaqah. The fitna of the man or the woman in their families, in their wealth, in their neighborhood will be expiated by salah, siyam, and sadaqah. So what does this mean, brothers and sisters? It means that if something happens, fitna means tribulation, it means difficulty, it means that if I get tested in my family, in my wealth, in my neighbors, and I did not pass the test, I did not give the rights of my money, my wealth, I did not give sadaqah, I did not give the rights of my family upon me, I didn't take the responsibility very good. And also, if I did not give my neighbors the rights, then my salah and my siyam and my sadaqah, inshallah, will expiate my sins. So in this hadith, here, siyam is included among the a'mal that expiates the sins. Then the previous hadith, it is taken by itself. Allah, the Prophet ﷺ is saying, Allah says, all a'mal are expiations except fasting. So it is singled out among all the a'mal to be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be unique because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unique, to be something distinguished because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is distinguishing the fasting people of Ramadan and other than Ramadan. Let's take another sahabi, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu anhuma. He said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, siyam, fasting, and Quran, they are intercessors for the servant on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, the day of judgment. Siyam will be saying, oh my Lord, I prevented him or her from eating, drinking, and desires during daytime. So please give me the chance to intercede for them. And Quran will be saying, oh my Lord, I prevented them from sleeping at night time. So please give me a chance to intercede for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant them the chance to intercede. So another hadith that Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As is narrating that siyam, fasting, general siyam, brothers, until now we did not speak about Ramadan, general siyam, and reading the Quran generally during the year, any time, especially the night time, that we said before, the best time for dua is the last part of the night. And if you are reading the Quran during that part, you are doing the best of the best. So siyam is considered an intercessor. It will come actually on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, and it will intercede for you. And in your grave, subhanAllah, it will be there. the Quran and the Siyam and the Sadaqah will come and they will surround you. And then when the angels want to come to you or something want to come to you, they will come and say, don't come, don't get him from my part. This is the Quran. And the Siyam will say, don't get him from here. So they are protecting you. In dunya, Siyam is protecting you physically from any disease and spiritually to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Quran is protecting you from any harm because Allah has made healing and cure in the Quran. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. We reveal from the Quran, which is shifa, healing, cure for the believers. So Siyam, fasting, and Quran, brothers and sisters, they are intercessors for us. And then we'll take also this hadith عن سيدنا أبي أمامة رضي الله عنه. He said, I came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I said, oh Messenger of Allah, please command me with something or tell me about something that if I do, I will go to Jannah. Give me a amal, a deed. I do, then it will give me the card to enter Jannah. This is Sayyidina Abi Umama. Then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him the card. What is it? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take fasting, there is nothing like it. And then he said, I came to him second time and I asked him the same question, oh Messenger of Allah, give me something I do that will grant me access to Jannah. The second time the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take fasting, there is nothing like it. Subhanallah. So this is an explanation of the virtues of fasting in general, brothers and sisters. So what about fasting in particular? What about the month of Ramadan? If we come and see the virtues of the month of Ramadan, we will take also a few hadith and see. Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, whoever fasts Ramadan in belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seeking the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive for them whatever they have committed from sins. And whoever stands up in salah during the night of decree, Laylatul Qadr, in belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seeking the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive them all their previous sins. So this is the first hadith now that we speak about the virtues of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to us through Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, telling us that those who fast, and we said in the first hadith, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah will widen the gap between us and Jahannam 70 years with one condition. The fasting should be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this condition is not easy to get. That's why if we fulfill that condition of ikhlas, that we don't have any shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we don't have any doubt, any partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the amal, then we get that. And here too, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying about Ramadan, whoever fasts Ramadan, believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this eliminates those who fast without believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, know that we are blessed to be Muslims. We are blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be mu'mins. Those others who do not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are not included in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Those who believe fast and they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then they seek the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are not fasting to show off. They are not fasting for someone else. They are not fasting for any other reason except to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to seek His forgiveness, to seek His pleasure subhanahu wa ta'ala during the month of Ramadan. So we gathered the blessed time of Ramadan and the blessed amal deed of ikhlas being just for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, giving everything for Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, then our previous sins are forgiven. So now we are getting all our sins to be cleaned up in one single month in the 12 month of the year, brothers and sisters. What do you think? Why Muslims all around the world, they are very waiting for the coming of the month of Ramadan, and they are questioning themselves, how come Ramadan this year is coming and it is the first year that we will not be able to access the masajid? How I am going to break my fast as usual, as I used to do in the masjid? How can I follow the imam in Taraweeh? How can I read my Quran? How can I do my tahajjud? How can I give my sadaqat? All these questions are coming into my mind and your minds, because we know the value of the month of Ramadan. It is a month, an annual audit for us in Sha'ban, that our deeds are getting up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in Ramadan, it is an annual forgiveness session. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us like a discount, a yearly discount for each and everything we are doing. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is eliminating all of our sins. Our sins and our records of bad deeds will go back to zero. Our slate will be very clean and white. That's why Muslims are waiting for that month of Ramadan, brothers and sisters. This is the first hadith that we have read so far about the month of Ramadan. What about the second hadith? Sayyidina Abu Hurairah too, he is the one who narrates the hadith that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when the first night of Ramadan comes, the first night of Ramadan comes, it is the night when we pray the first Taraweeh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chains the shayateen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chains the shayateen. And then those rebels from jinn too, shayateen, Satan and his followers, and also the rebels from jinn, and all doors of Jahannam, all gates of fire will be closed. No single door will be opened. And all gates of Jannah will be opened. No single door is closed. A caller will call. All seekers of goodness, come forward. This is the time for you. Oh, seekers of evil, stop, go back. This is not the time for you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take away many people from the fire. And this is every night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will release many of us whose record was made to go to the fire. Wal'audhu billah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us the salvation during the first night of the month of Ramadan. So this is a very good hadith, very important hadith. Rawah al-Imam Ibn Majah, and narrated by Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. We want to contemplate about this hadith, brothers and sisters, for today. When the first night of Ramadan comes, which is the last day of Sha'ban, and Ramadan is tomorrow. So at Maghrib time, then this is the first night of Ramadan. We start Salat al-Isha, and we start the first Taraweeh. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is talking about in this hadith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chains the shayateen, all the shayateen, Satan and his followers. And then also the rebels of jinn are also chained, and all doors of Jahannam are closed. No single door is opened, and all doors of Jannah are opened. No single door is closed, and a caller from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling, O seekers of goodness, come forward. This is the season of goodness. So you come because Ramadan has come. You are waiting for this. Seekers of goodness, come forward. And seekers of evil, stop, quit. This is not the right time for you. Go back, stop, repent. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will free from Jahannam many people. And this is every night of the month of Ramadan. Subhanallah. Brothers and sisters, these ahadith are amazing ahadith. They are telling us a lot about the month of Ramadan. And that's why we miss our beloved month of Ramadan in the masajid. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the strength of iman to be able to endure that, to take that, to be away from our masajid, to be away from the places of ibadah during that month of Ramadan, because of that COVID-19 that has become an epidemic and pandemic, and it is widely spread around the world, and the masajid are closed for the Muslims, and most of the businesses are closed, and everybody is staying home. But brothers and sisters, never give up. Rahmatullah. Rahmatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala can come to you at home. The forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can come to you at your house. The fleeing and freeing those who will be freed from Jahannam in the first night and every night. Me and you can be among those while we are praying and reading at home, teaching our children. Ramadan this year will be a different Ramadan. So please, brothers and sisters, make it a big difference in your life. Make this Ramadan matters for you and your family. Make it is a different month during the whole life. We may not see Ramadan in this situation anymore in our lives. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to show us this again, so we can come to the masajid inshallah in the next Ramadan. I will take you to the last hadith in speaking about the virtues of the month of Ramadan. It is also Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrating the hadith when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was going up to the minbar to give the khutbah, and he said, Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. We mentioned this hadith before about the timing of the accepted dua. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was going up, Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. We know that the steps of the minbar of the Prophet were three steps. In each one, he said, Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. And then it was said, O Messenger of Allah, why did you said so? He said, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Jibreel came to me and he said, those who live with their parents or one of them and they don't get him or her to Jannah, they will be prevented. Say Ameen, Muhammad. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ameen. And then he said, those that Ramadan come and goes and their sins are not forgiven, they are the prevented ones. Say Ameen, Muhammad. So the Prophet said, Ameen. And he said, also said, those that your name, Muhammad, is mentioned in front of them, and they don't send salah and salam upon you, they are the real prevented ones. Say Ameen. I said Ameen. So here in this hadith also, brothers and sisters, Ramadan is a season of forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us through Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those who are prevented rahmatullah in Ramadan are the real prevented ones. Those are the most miserable ones, because the season of forgiveness has come at their doors and they rejected rahmatullah and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are not sure if we are going to make it to the next year to witness Ramadan or not. So brothers and sisters, these are some of the virtues of the fasting in general and Ramadan in particular. Just to summarize what we have said, fasting one day for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will widen the gap between us and Jahannam 70 years. And also Siyam is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All other deeds expiate our sins, but Siyam is for Allah, and He is the one subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards for it. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Siyam is for me and I am the one who rewards for it. And also Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that Siyam and Quran intercede for the Muslim on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. And when he was asked about an advice, a remedy, a prescription to give to Abi Umama to let him go to Jannah, to give him an access card to Jannah, he said, Siyam, fasting, there is nothing that equals it. Take it and Allah will get you into Jannah. And about the virtues of the month of Ramadan, we have spoken about the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If we fast and we are believers seeking the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all our sins are forgiven. The first night of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the doors of Jannah, closes the doors of Jahannam, chains the shayateen and the rebels of jinn, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala will be fleeing and freeing many Muslims from Jahannam each and every night. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us if we submit to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan. So brothers and sisters, those who have committed sins, who doesn't? All of us, we are sinners. But the best among sinners are those who come to Allah in repentance, as the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. So repent now. Don't wait and say, inshallah, Ramadan is coming, I'm going to repent for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan. You never know if we are going to live for another day or two. Some of us may not even witness Ramadan after 10 or 9 days. So commit now that you are, inshallah, doing tawbah today, tonight, and then be ready for this season of ibadah, this season of forgiveness, this season of compassion and love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to His servants. Show Him subhanahu wa ta'ala the best of yourselves. He subhanahu wa ta'ala will show you amazingly His rahmah and maghfirah in your life, inshallah, bi'idhnillah. Brothers and sisters, do not forget us in your dua. Do not forget the masjid, Ottawa Muslim Association, for your dua and the volunteers who work here. And also please, with this video, we will have a link so you can go and donate and support the masjid during Ramadan. As you always know, masajid depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your donations. And Ramadan is the big season for the masajid, subhanallah, and the masajid are going to miss that. The musalleen will not be there, and also the financial aid will not be there. So please, brothers and sisters, do what you used to do in the masjid. You go online and try to donate and click on that link. If you want to commit for a couple of months or 1 year to give certain amount, so please send us a voided check, or you can do it online, inshallah, bi'idhnillah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you. He subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. And the sadaqah will help us all, inshallah, bi'idhnillah, to get out from this coronavirus, inshallah, bi'idhnillah, stronger in our faith, closer to our Lord. I say what I say, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all of us. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala His rahmah and maghfirah. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our community. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help humanity to come together around some cure for this virus. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala for those brothers and sisters who passed away, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants them Jannah, that He subhanahu wa ta'ala grants them Maghfirah. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala for those brothers and sisters of ours in the community who are suffering from any disease or any accidents, that He subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them the shifa and the speedy recovery. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.